Today we talk about how to learn from customers and how to transform their feedback into improvements and change for your entire organization. I hope you liked part one. Here is part two. The first technical complications arise with the second step of the process, as we call it, data handling. It comprises all the steps starting from finding where the customer feedback is to the point where it becomes available to be analyzed. Thinking that this step is simple is the biggest mistake that a brand can do, because every imperfection in this first phase has consequences throughout the entire process. To make a practical example, think about a brand that collects customer feedback about one specific product, but during the data handling process, attributes these records to another one. The decisions made at the end of the analysis would be completely wrong, with potentially catastrophic results. I can guarantee that these mistakes happen very often, especially if brands sell hundreds or thousands of different SKUs. So this step is crucial and difficult because it's composed of many different components. We're talking about data collection and data preparation. Data collection generally consists of scrapers to download data from the web, API connectors to ingest data from internal sources, and collection tools to generate new data. On the other side, you have data preparation or data normalization tools that often deal with data cleansing, anonymization, and translation. Each of these technologies reaches a very high level of complexity. That's why companies should better work with external providers and do not try to do it themselves in-house. In the description, you will find another video where I explain more extensively why brands shouldn't do things in-house. Many things. The third step of this customer-centric process is data analysis. The goal is to have customer feedback processed and interpreted as humans would do, but ideally more consistently and at scale. This first analysis can be followed by a data enrichment phase, where results are visualized in a comprehensive way and even used to make predictions about the future of customer behavior and their performance. To execute the data analysis part, brands need natural language processing technologies, so-called NLP. Or they need to do the analysis manually using an annotation tool. NLP is the best choice because of its infinite scalability. However, it's also possible to get started with humans doing the job. At the same time, keep in mind that NLP programs are based on experimental and very complex technologies. Therefore, it requires knowledge and experience to really leverage them. The same applies to descriptive and predictive capabilities, where NLP meets statistics. Due to the complexity of this matter, especially for this phase, brands should really rely on external providers. This is not something that you can give it a try if you're not an expert. The last and fourth step is reporting. The components of a reporting system usually are a dashboard, an app, or an export system that can be connected to internal visualization tools. Having good tools in place is important, as data becomes usable only when correctly visualized. Charts and smart presentations are key to deliver predictions and recommendations directly to the desks of decision makers. It's also true that nowadays companies have many different dashboards and that users sometimes end up spending more time to learn how to use the platforms than actually studying the insights that they provide. In this case, using an external provider that has a dashboard but also API connectors is for sure the best solution. So let's recap from the very beginning. Brands want to be customer-centric to be more successful. In order to do so, they need to interpret customer feedback. It is difficult to analyze this type of content as it requires the brand to have competencies and tools that cover four crucial steps: strategy, data handling, data analysis, and reporting. Which of these steps is the most difficult? That's a good question for you. Let me know in the comments and see you soon.